Hello, it's Shadow the Rat, and today I thought I'd do a voiceover of my video on how to make a DIY playpen for rats. So the first thing you'll need to do is gather some materials. I use various cardboard boxes, Gorilla tape or duct tape, scissors, and 4 large binder clips. Now for your cardboard boxes, I suggest you try to get some around the same size, as this will make making your playpen much easier. If you can't find boxes around the same size, you can use different sized ones. However, it may take longer to make your playpen, as you will need to cut each box to size. Once you've gathered all your material together, you should break down your first box. You can do this by taking it apart until all corners align flat against each other. Next, you'll want to make a cut down one side of the box and lay it flat on the ground. The next thing you'll want to do is tape up all the cracks in your cardboard from the box flaps. Be sure to tape up both the front and the back of the cardboard to give it extra stability. Once you've taped up your first box, you'll want to repeat both steps with another box. Now that you have 2 taped up boxes, lay them next to each other and align the cracks. Next, place a long stretch of tape down the crack. Be sure to tape both sides of the cardboard, again, to add more stability. You'll want to continue to tape up the boxes and connect them together until you're satisfied with the size of your cardboard fence. Depending on your box size, you'll need a different amount to make different size playpens. The playpen I usually use is around the size of my room, and I'd say that this uses around 5 to 6 boxes. Once you've connected together all your boxes, it's time to stand up the playpen. Now you'll want to overlap the ends of your playpen. I'd recommend overlapping your playpen's edges by around 4 to 5 inches, as this way you can ensure that you'll have enough room to clip on the binder clips. Now clip on the binder clips to the bottom and top of this overlapped edge. All that's left is to spread out the rest of the playpen and add toys. Once you finish putting out toys, you can put out your rats and let them run around. And that's really all there is to it. The great thing about these playpens is that not only are they easy to make, but you can make them as big or as small as you would like them to be. For example, the playpen I use for taming is pretty small, only a little bit bigger than me when I'm sitting in there cross-legged. However, the playpen I use for my tame rats is much larger, spanning about the size of my room. Now you'll have to remember, these playpens aren't infallible. Many times, rats will try to dig under or jump out. I have trained my girls to jump onto my shoulder when they would like out of the playpen,
which greatly curbs their jumping and digging behaviors.
Adding enrichment to the playpen is another way to make sure that your rats don't get bored and try to jump out. I like to make towers for my rats, using chairs, boxes, and anything I can get a hold of.
I also use my playpen as a training area for my rats.
Since my rats are used to free-ranging here, it's easy enough for them to concentrate when I would like to train them.
And when I'm done with my playpen, it's easy enough to put everything away and then fold it up for easy storage.
Thanks for watching, and I hope this video was helpful.